Hello, Maureen.
How are you?
Fine.
My name is Ronald Dianga. I am a farmer back in Migori County in Kenya. I farm maize.
My name is Janet Toraitich. I am a farm influencer from Kenya. I farm wheat and coffee.
Fantastic.
And I'm happy to be part of the Yara Shujaa Exchange here in Migori.
On my name is Rogers Kirwa, alias Mr. Agriculture on the social media platforms. I'm a farmer back in Kenya. I do corn, maize, that's maize. I also do a bit of dairy and also have a tea farm. I'm here today in Oslo for the Yara Exchange Program.
So I'm here in Kenya and I would like to learn more about the opportunities and challenges that are faced by young African farmers.
This story begins, you know, when we met the Yara CEO and president, Sven Tore, back in Kenya on a farm, where he had come to see the impact of the different products and services that Yara provides, or that Yara develops. We had a conversation about how do we position young people, together with my colleagues, Shujaaz, which is an alternative word for champions in Swahili. And he was particularly excited about how we are leveraging on social media to be a platform of influence to get other young people excited in the lens of really the work that we are doing on individual farms.
He jokingly said, "I will have you guys over." And that's how we are here today.
Coming up to the Yara offices, I think I almost forgot my bag in the car because the excitement. As I came through the door, I think it felt like this is the home where it all happens.
There was a presentation on global innovation and what Yara does across the world. So it was really an interesting one. And after that, we proceeded for a lunch.
There were all these many people who were asking questions about what we do, excited about, you know, seeing us and receiving us, which is kind of not what we expected.
And I think I got the reassurance that I'll be having a lot of fun during the week.
We proceeded to the Mock Museum. We really interacted with lots of art.
So I think it's very expressive.
Well, you know where I come from. Art is not really a thing. But it was beautiful. I was trying. I tried to see what people were looking at.
After the Mock Museum, we proceeded to the restaurant there was at the Mock Museum where we had dinner.
One of the most interesting conversation we had, you know, humorous person of the day, was Christine, who happens to be the executive vice president of Yara. We felt that definitely we were well received and we were well taken care of.
Good to see you. Hello, good to see you again. Oh, yeah.
The biggest reason why we came to Nuri is to meet our CEO.
We went to Sylvain Sophie's, we got to interact, had a Q&A.
Share from your perspective, what exactly as a company are you doing to influence, you know, the farmer prosperity?
The most important discussions we had was when he was talking about the coffee farmers. I personally, I am a coffee farmer.
But you're saying that right now the profitability of coffee farming is low. So.
Our farmers really do a lot to ensure that we have coffee that is really sold out here in the international market. Yet the reward they get as farmers is really still very minimal.
And if you take up to 5 months, 6 months, then it will still not a guarantee that you will get paid.
It's 5-6 months after you have delivered?
Yes.
I saw his interest in supporting the coffee farmers.
It was really interesting to have this discussion with Vane and later proceeded for
the live session.
No stress, but don't say anything wrong.
Thank you very much to everybody who is joining us from all over around the world.
coming into that live session and just having the opportunity to moderate it gave me a really clear picture of the passion and vision that Sventoria has for youth engagement in agriculture.
Really excited about this meeting. This will be one of my most important meetings this year.
And really leveraging on the different individual voices that are really authentic, sharing farm experiences like we did on that live event.
How do we get the best practice spread? How do we create policies? How do we drive this? I really would like to hear from you on your views on that, and how could I contribute, but how could also other organizations contribute to help on that journey?
This is something we do, part of being an agricultural influencer. You don't get to meet the president and the CEO easily. So it was such a big day.
In Kenya, like not everyone would take coffee because coffee is a bit classy.
I drink a lot of tea personally. I am a coffee farmer and I don't drink coffee, but I'm willing to test today.
I personally never used to be a big fan of coffee, but I needed it to stay up at night and work. And so when I had the opportunity to taste some coffee in one of the most renowned coffee shops here in Oslo, I think I was looking forward to it.
But guys, welcome to us.
We have a lot of Kenyan coffees. Right now we have coffee from Karagoto.
The highlight was just knowing where the coffee was from.
Tim is somebody who really goes out there and gets to support farmers.
I think it's very exciting that there are people willing to pay for a good product and knowing where that particular product comes from.
So we had coffee from Kenya. We had coffee from across the world.
Kenya.
Yeah,
I'd take coffee now.
Karen, how are you?
We proceeded to Norfund. Okay. Norfund is a Norwegian investment that really works back at home in Africa.
And so that means that also in the offices...
I met a Kenyan as part of the group in Norfund, which was really amazing, amazing. I felt we could relate, and I was so happy that they were talking about farmers.
It was amazing to get to know that Norfund have even invested in projects in Kenya.
In the morning, a very long drive to Porsgrunn.
We went past a grocery store.
I think going into that grocery store, I mean, the first exciting thing was for me was the naming, the names of those particular crops.
Agurk.
But also number two, they're able to trace back onto what farm that particular product comes from. We don't get that a lot in Kenya.
Tomato. A girl.
Red onion.
Just big. We have pumpkins, but not the same kind. That's what I saw there was what I see in Halloween movies. Yeah. Next, we went to the Norwegian farmer.
Hello.
I was happy to meet a woman farmer.
Yes. So now we are on Skordemure farm, where I was born and my grandmother's way back. For about 150 years, this farm has been in my family. This is Sørlandschips. You can read on the back of the bag what farm it comes from. So this is our farm, Ringdal Gård.
And it's every farmer's dream to produce and then see your product on the other side of the market.
So in the context of food safety, I think traceability is critical and key. But number two is just being able to also appreciate the work that was done by your farmer.
For farmers back at home, there's no value addition at the farm level. You harvest your crop, give it out to the brokers get it to the factories, and the processing is done there. But for this farmer here, the farmer grows the crop, does some value addition, and even keeps some produce and even sells through the season.
So it's no harvesting before August break.
Just trying to stress the pumpkin.
And what's the temperature is like?
But it was interesting to see that these farmers, how they operate their farms, is quite similar to what we do. Though here, there are lots of machinery compared to back at home. We still use manual labor to really harvest all these crops from the farm. I've not seen snow before. This is my first time experiencing snow.
It's like, it's unbelievable for us, and of course we want to experience that snow. One of the, I think, the most important places that we're looking forward to going to is the research center, and where, you know, the real stuff is done.
You're a rock star.
The research center is where research is done before production really goes out there.
Thank you.
Testing is done before farmers are given the product.
They do their research relating to the soil or where they're sending their products to. All farmers are not the same. Farmers have different needs. Such organizations are very important to assist the farmers understand how best they can feed their plants.
We have issues of climate change. We have issues of soil health. So it is important that we do research before we produce what we produce.
Just listening into the scientists, Yara definitely has significantly reduced the emissions. Yeah, and I think the commitment is even going further to look at possible ways and innovations of how they can further reduce that. It was great to hear. They were very keen to listen to our feedback, because at the end of the day, they are working to help me stay in business so that my farm can ultimately continue.
After the research center, we proceeded to the Yara Villa.
There's no better way to end the day by pulling up to this amazing cottage.
Welcome to Yara's house.
We had a view of the lake.
And you could see the whole thing, which was perfect.
Welcome to Norway.
Yeah. We got up the next day.
I'm just thinking, at least today is the day we're going to see the plants. When we pull up and I'm like, wow.
We met Ragnar. I was happy that the person who was leading us was a woman.
I have heard it's, you know, one of the largest NPK producers plant in the world.
Where we're going now used to be the tallest building in Norway when it was built.
Wow. The view from the top of that tower was really nice.
It was amazing. Amazing is an understatement. It was just wonderful.
I think I kind of took like 50 plus photos of that particular view. In fact, I posted on my Instagram.
Spectacular.
Perfect. Beautiful.
When I came down and then got to scoop the crystals, and I was like, wow.
Well, yeah, this is Yara Mila.
Yara Mila.
It's a Yara Mila, it's one.
It's an NPK, Yara Mila. Yeah, we use a lot of Yara Mila, either in tea, coffee, or even maize.
This is really the lifeblood of my science.
Yara!
We go to the packaging area.
I wish I could meet the person who designed the bag. It's just not a bag. There's just something beautiful about it.
The calcium nitrate has a wide range of use, also outside the agro sector.
We use this for our horticulture crops. If you observe that your flowers are falling just immediately after flowering, this is the best remedy.
Because of the fact that it has got nitrogen, which is very important for the bulbing of the onions.
Yara Liver Nutrable is a premium product in Kenya.
This was the culmination of the trip. We had a beautiful experience there.
Yara fertilizer is quality. With no doubt, I have really got a lot of knowledge from Yara. I'm half the farmer I am because of Yara.
I think I've taken like anywhere between 200 and 300 photos.
Today, you mean? 3 to 4 hours?
I think so. On the plant alone.
We've taken, I think, as many videos as we could just to enjoy, you know, the beauty of seeing snowfall. It's my first time actually to see a snowfall.
This trip is an eye-opener to me as a farmer, as a small, older farmer in Kenya.
There's a lot of things that happens behind the scenes from the people that drive this particular brand. It was so fun that they were eager, every one of them, to listen to them. For a moment, I felt like the representative voice of the farmer was really being heard.